Get ready to revolutionize your home screen with Tasker's new V2 widgets. You can now also remotely automate your life with remote action execution. Check out the new Tasker.
Widget V2.
Tasker can now create customized icons on your home screen for you. You don't think that's impressive? Can your regular home icons scroll? Like this? What about expanding them so more buttons show if needed? Can your icons change depending on if you're at home or at work? With Tasker's new Widget V2, you can even have a whole screen full of customizable actions if you really want to. Widget V2 allows you to very easily use a bunch of presets like the aforementioned icons and also a simple circular image, a table like with this example weather widget, or even a media player-like layout that you can use for whatever you want. In this example, I can control multiple music apps and seamlessly switch from Spotify to Google Play Music with the tap of a button. More presets can be added by the developer, so if you can think of a preset that would be useful for a lot of people, ask me to add it.
Widget V2 Custom Layout.
Ready to take it to the next level? Enter the Tasker Widget V2 Custom Layout. You can edit Tasker's custom widgets with a simple widget editor and make it look exactly like you want them to. Want to build a home automation dashboard for your home screen? No problem. Wouldn't it be cool if you could catch up on the latest Reddit news without even opening an app? Here you go. You're bored and want to play a slide puzzle on your home screen? You can do that too. Just to show you how flexible the widget builder is, here are a couple of recreations of popular widgets that I built with Tasker. The YouTube widget. At the top, you can see the original widget, and at the bottom, you can see the version I built with Tasker. The Alexa shopping list. Again, top is the original one, and bottom is mine. Can you tell the difference? As mentioned, all these custom widgets can be built with a simple-to-use widget editor. You can see and test changes right away when editing a widget, so you know exactly what you'll end up with. No more excuses for a boring, static home screen. Bring your launcher to life with Tasker Widget V2.
Remote action execution.
Tasker can now natively run its actions on remote devices. If you add a new action and search for remote, you'll see all the actions that support this. Stuff like get location, browse URL, or set clipboard can now be ran remotely. For example, you can run the get location V2 action on your remote device, get back its location from it, and then show that location on your local device. Likewise, you could get your location locally and show it on the remote device. All you need to do is select on which device you want an action to run, and it'll run as part of your normal task execution. And I haven't even shown you the best part. You can also use the perform task action remotely to run any task on your remote device and get back any variables that result from that task. For example, you could create a Tasker Widget V2 on your home screen that shows you any info you want about your remote device. In this example, I'm showing you the device name, Bluetooth status, battery info, and location. And I can even click on the Bluetooth icon to toggle it remotely. For the more technically inclined, you can even run your tasks remotely from anywhere by calling the Firebase Cloud Messaging Service directly with your credentials. This means that you can automate your device from a web page, a web server, or anywhere where you can send an HTTP request from.
Other stuff.
Renaming files on an external drive will now be instantaneous instead of having to copy the file and deleting the original. You can now get Material 3 design tokens from the Get Material U Colors action, so you can more easily choose your colors. For people with special accessibility needs,
work 2, width, move up, double, move down.
You can now move actions up and down with Talkback.
Work 3, move up, move down.
Check out the new Tasker.